Please welcome Joel Edgerton. Nice to have you back at Channel 10, Secret Life of Us, where it all began.
Yeah.
Welcome home.
No denying it. I love it.
Back where you belong.
People that deny their past. I'm not one of them.
Well, congratulations on the film.
Thank you.
You pull off an incredible American accent in the film.
Yeah.
You're playing an American. I guess, how... Whenever we hear someone do our accent, though, we're always like, is that real?
Mm.
So to us, your American accent sounds perfect.
Have you seen Neutron, Jacob?
Yes.
Caleb Landry-Jones is one of the people that nailed it.
Yeah.
The reason I reckon Australians are good at it is because we were bombarded with American television when we were kids.
Yeah.
I grew up in the 80s. Long time ago. And all we watched was American television.
Yeah.
Gilligan's Island, Brady Bunch, 80s, like, you name it.
I would say those characters are slightly lighter than the character you play in this.
Yeah. As I play.
Do Americans think that you do a great American accent, though?
I think they say that I do. I sometimes wonder if they're just being ultra polite.
Yeah.
American.
Yes. Huh?
They're being American.
They're being American. Yeah.
This isn't the most obvious story to tell. What drew you to this project?
Look, George Clooney, I guess, is, you know, like, he was directing it, and when he told me about it, I'd never heard of this story. Mm. And it's one of those sports stories that when you hear it, you're like, oh, this is perfectly built for a movie. Every single thing that happens is kind of perfectly built for a film, you know. Mm-hmm. Particularly that where they end up is at the Olympics in front of Hitler, you know. Who doesn't love putting Hitler in his place?
And did they really row in front of Hitler? Was that bit of a...
Yeah, and I think he was pretty unhappy about it too.
Great.
I mean, the real story of that Olympics was Jesse Owens, but we've, you know, that's been made into a movie before. But these guys achieved something remarkable. They were poor kids. They didn't really want to be rowers. They were just trying to get a roof over their head and food on the table. And if they joined the team, they could do that. And then they just kept winning. Unlike me.
Well, George Clooney is known for being a bit of a prankster on set. Is when he's sort of directing things, is he still a prankster, or he like now because he's the boss of everything? He's like, oh, I'm going to keep it profesh, guys.
You know, I actually started to think he mustn't like me very much because he didn't prank me at all, unless I'm so stupid that I don't realise that I didn't pick up on it.
Were you kind of looking over your shoulder the whole time, thinking it's going to happen?
No, I didn't. You know, some of his pranks are legendary.
Yes.
In fact, I wouldn't even try and tell some of them here because they're too disgusting. Some of them. Like, just Google George pranks and, you know, get disgusted. But he didn't prank anyone. I think he was taking it all very seriously and doing a great job. Yeah, but we didn't... I've got to call him and say, now I demand you prank me.
Yeah, now I've passed my initiation.
I feel unloved.
It's got inside your head.
Yeah, I'm unloved.
You also had a bit of a dinner the night before you were supposed to start shooting, and most of the people left that dinner with COVID. Please tell me that everything kind of went better.
I've still got it. It's going to rip through this.
Excellent.
It was a great prank.
Yeah.
Maybe that was the one he brought a little petri dish. The legendary cast dinner, which I thought post-COVID was a thing of the past now. Because it was George, we held it in this really private, really tiny cellar door kind of room. Yeah, an incubator. And within 3 weeks, every single member of that dinner had COVID, except for one, I think, who'd just previously had it. But
Did you work out who patient X was?
Well, George has decided in the last year that I'm patient zero. Now that I'm in Australia, I can set the record straight. Because I remember I've been running around telling everyone that George Clooney gave me COVID. Which for some reason just feels like a cool thing to say. George Clooney gave me COVID.
Yeah.
Who gave you COVID?
Yeah, well...
George Clooney.
So, in this, you play the coach of the rowing team.
Yeah.
The rowers themselves, the actors who played the rowers, they would have had to go through a lot of extensive training for that. It would have had to be really fit. Did you have to sort of... To get into the role, did you have to watch a lot of rowing? Did you have to, you know, give some inspirational speeches? What was your prep?
Well, I watched a lot of television. full stop. I watched a lot of football games and various sporting events, basketball, where you just see those coaches that look like they're on the verge of a heart attack.
Yeah.
Just pacing and...
Yeah, because in the script he's described as someone who never smiles. And I was like, I remember, like, growing up watching, like, Jack Gibson you know, coaching the Parramatta Eels. I was an avid supporter when I was a kid, and just those guys who look like, why are you doing this? You don't look like you're having any fun at all. But it's because they care so much about their sport. Mm. So I did a lot of that, but I didn't have to row. I'm older now, so I don't have to be an athlete.
You mentioned Secret Life of Us earlier.
Yeah.
Did you expect that more than 20 years on, we'd still be watching it?
Everyone's I thought you were going to say that I'd still be working. Still have a job?
Yeah. George Clooney asked us to ask that question.
That people would still be watching it. Yeah, I hear it's like, are people... Yeah,
it's
there
awesome.
I am.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
It's back again, baby.
I don't know. I sort of hate being old, but when I look at that, I'm like, I'm kind of glad I don't look like that. Take that hair off me, please.
Oh, my God. Well, the boys in the boat arrives in cinemas on January 4. It's great to see you. Would you please thank Joel Edgerton? Thank you. Thank you.